So now let's start with drilling operation. Till now we have seen shaping and planning operations and turning operation. So in the drilling operation, the feed is divided into two loops because my drill is coming downwards and there are two faces. If we see the cross section, there are two faces. So due to that, we will model in such a way that the feed is divided into two loops. Therefore, given a feed F to the tool, each loop is going to have experience of feed. So this is F. Feed of F by 2. So that's the important change which is happening. Other all the things will remain same. So earlier we had T1, the uncut chip thickness is equal to F sine beta or cos. So we can use any of those. The beta complementary angle will come into picture. So the beta is defined as semi-leap angle. So that is not the same as cutting edge angle or side cutting edge angle. Over here we are using it using the semi-leap angle or the leap angle, that is the angle of the tool. The tool geometry is giving us again. Over there also, the side cutting edge angle was coming from the tool geometry itself. So the modeling has resulted into these equations, and they need not be proved anytime. They are just the empirical equations or trigonometric equations we are referring. So you just need to remember this. So, or they can be given in the question which you are going to solve. So generally, these relations are given because some relations go very large. So earlier we have already seen the equivalent alpha angle, that is the rake surface angle. That the equation or the formula was very complex. So generally those formulas will be given in the question paper itself. Now let's come back. So the T1 uncut chip thickness is given as F by 2, feed by 2 into sine beta. And the width of cut is given by depth of cut divided by 2 into divided by sine beta. So actually it will be D by 2 sine beta. So, and the capital D is the diameter of the drill bit. The drill bit is the part that the threaded part which you see, which is going to do the drilling operation, which you fit in front of the drill machine. So if the drill machine is starting from here, in the front, which you, the part which you add, which has different diameter, different shapes, that is the drill bit. And over here also, we are defining alpha. So that is the equivalent alpha angle, that is tan inverse of 2r by d into tan psi by sine beta. So these are also coming from empirical relations, and you need not remember or prove this. R is the radial position of the reference. So this is an important part. So since this is how a drill bit will come into the picture, we have a drill bit like this, and from center, this is the diameter D. This will be D by 2. And this is the some any radial position R. So this R will change from 0 to D by 2. So that's the meaning of R. So instead of taking varying values of R, we can take an assumed average value of R also. So that will be done generally. And F, the total force is given by 2Ft sine beta plus FCH plus F friction. And M is given by FC into Z. So that Z will be the distance which is given. And MCH plus M friction. So these are the moments. This is the force equation. This is the moment equation. But this getting MCH, FCH are very tough. And they can be continuously varying also sometimes. So we have made a simpler equation in terms of what we have known earlier also, which is easier for us to understand. So M is approximated as 0.6 into FC into D. FC is already known, the cutting force. This is the diameter. So we have got the torque, and F, that is the total force, is phi FB into sine beta. Thrust force in transition. So this is the thrust force at the transitional surface. That is not of the permanent surface. That is the surface generated during the machining. So everywhere we will use these equations only to find the value of moment and force, wherever we require. We need not use this long equation anytime. So we'll stop over here. In the next video, we'll look at a numerical question on drilling operation. Thank you.